الحمد لله الذي لم يزل عالما قديرا وصلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Do not ever befriend a backbiter. The one who backbites, the one who comes to you discussing the life of other, exposing the lives of other, sharing the secrets of others, revealing the secrets of other to you, be sure that tomorrow is your turn. Tomorrow he will reveal your secrets. Tomorrow he will discuss your life, because this is his habit. He has got a soul disease, a person who is suffering from any disease, so he is always suffering from that disease. So he suffered the pains of that disease. In the same way, ghiba, the backbiting, it is a soul disease, so he is suffering from that disease. So once he is backbiting others to you, he is revealing the secrets of other to you, you are his friend. Tomorrow is your turn, and he will share your secret with others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has compared it with eating the flesh of a Muslim. أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ, that any one of you likes to eat the flesh of his Muslim brother, the dead Muslim? No, we cannot eat the flesh of our Muslim brothers. So then how we can backbite our Muslim brothers? Abu Dharr Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one of the companions of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once he asked about ghiba. He said, Ya Rasulullah, what is ghiba? Mal ghiba? The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that ghiba is to mention something of your brothers that he dislikes, he detests. So when you mention, make mention of that thing, that is ghiba. So Abu Dharr Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he asked the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Oh, the beloved Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what if what is mentioned is actually in him? Should actually be in him then? The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that is ghiba. If you mention something that is actually not in him, so you are slandering him. This is not ghiba. So ghiba is that sometimes, it is a very common, you can say, saying that when we make mention of some, you can say that the faults of the people, the errors of the people, the mistakes of the people, some bad habits of the people. So we just, you can say very openly say that, oh, I'm not telling a lie. These things actually exist in him. So when these bad things exist in him, that is ghiba. Otherwise, if they do not exist in him, then this is a buhtan, it is slandering. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Hazrat Abu Dharr Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Oh Abu Dharr Ghifari, remember that backbiting is actually, when you backbite a Muslim brother, so this is a graver sin than zina, then adultery. Abu Dharr Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Ya Rasulullah, how is that? Zina compared to backbiting, I think backbiting seems to be very slighter than that. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, No, Abu Dharr, when a person commits adultery, zina, and he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives him. But when a person, he does ghiba of a Muslim brothers, so he should be forgiven that victim. Otherwise, his sin is not forgiven. So to conclude, we can say, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that no fire is, you can say, faster than ghiba in consuming the dry wood. Is the fire, it consumes the dry wood very fast. But the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that ghiba consumes the virtues, the good deeds of a Muslim faster than a fire that consumes the wood, the dry wood. In the same way, according to the hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is backbiting the Muslim is a great sin, a major sin. In the same way, listening to the backbiting is also a great sin. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that listener to backbiting is the two of backbiters, because there are two backbiters. One is backbiting and second one is listening to me. So they both are the partner in you can say the gaining the you can say the bad effects of backbiting. They both are involved in backbiting, because one is backbiting and the second one is enjoying to him, listening and just you can say provoking him, and you can say just pushing him to say something more about, to share something more about that person. So in this, according to this hadith, the listener and the backbiter, they both are the sharik in guna. They both are, you can say, sharik in this ism, in these bad deeds. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi.